So we will move on to the next paragraph. So this paragraph from here to here tells us that the company, that the Couchweb does not charge differential prices for popular movie, for popular TV programs or for new movies. So the plus point is the company is not, there's no differential pricing as of now. In future, Couchweb can gain more revenue by using a differential pricing strategy. So they have given this information here. And this paragraph here tells us simply that the movies and the TV, the content which is created by the Couchweb is currently, which is being like telecasted in countries like English speaking countries. But if they want to telecast the same movie into another country, they just need to create a, I think it will be somewhere here, it is dubbed. Okay, so the content will be dubbed from English to French and the movie will be played out in the, it will be streamed. Okay, so that's what they actually tell here. So that's about the page number 6. Page number 6 also continues here. Here he says that the, once a customer purchases the subscription and he becomes a customer to the company, he will be allowed to view the content through to 3 devices. So a family can buy the subscription rights and they can view it from 3 devices. So one for the father, one for mother, and for the one for son. You can even say it like that. So it gives much more flexibility in terms of watching the content here. So currently how people are watching the content, so that is given in this paragraph. There's something called as the concept called as binge watching, where people are watching a large, they don't wait for a week after week or month after month to view a serial. What they do is they wait for the serial to come from month to month. They sit on a particular some 2-3 days or a week, they watch the entire program over that 2-3 days or a week time, and they finish it. So what is a good thing and bad thing? See, binge watching is a problem for the company, because if the customer has to watch the episodes every week after week or month after month, he has to pay a subscription. But if he's going to binge watch it, then he might just buy 1 month subscription, he might view all the content, and finally he might unsubscribe in the next month. So again, there's some kind of volatility in the income. So this part actually leads to something called as a volatility in income. So volatile income. So that's about it about this paragraph. We'll move on to this paragraph. Couchweb concentrates most of its production effort on TV programs rather than movies. So this is an important key element here. This is a very key element here, because there are two types of content. One is TV programs, another one is movies. So this company is concentrating on TV programs rather than movies. So always have this information in your mind. Couchweb is keen on TV programs than movies. These tend to be popular with subscribers. Couchweb produces more of its own content, so it allows the Couchweb to have control over the content. They don't need to depend upon another production house to have control over the content, and that's a good thing about producing their own TV programs and movies. Couchweb has a reputation for being willing to take risks in buying programs that are different and interesting. So the company buys interesting and different kind of programs, they produce it and they even buy it. But it is a risk. When you do something new, it is always a risk. But that risk offers you one upside but also a downside. So the company takes a risk. So only after producing it and after launching it, the company will come to know whether it's a good risk or a bad risk. So here they tell what is the current television show that is being like aired. They say that the Couchweb, the politics game, is presently in its third season and is most popular show. And here they tell you something else. Couchweb's only other significant source of revenue is generated from DVD sales of the programs that it commissions itself. Okay, so whatever programs that the Couchweb creates, they also create a DVD for it and they also sell it. So this information will be discussed in detail in the next page. Okay, so here they tell about programming. This entire thing can be classified into this table here, to this chart here. Okay, so there are contents are of two types. One is movies, another one is TV program. TV programs are of two types. One is series, another one is serial. What is series? Series is every episode has one story. So that one story will get over by that series itself. But what is serial? Serial is something which keeps on continuing for month after month or week after week in each episode. So that's about page number 7. So in this page and in this paragraph, they tell about the serial. Okay, serial offers better subscription retention as the serial is over a period of 2 to 3 months. So each serial has 13 episodes. I assume that for every week there is going to be one episode. So that spreads the total amount of series into 2 to 3 months. So the company can be sure that at least for this 2 to 3 months, they are going to get the subscription here. Okay, so that's what it is. And a popular program may have one or two series released every year. So look at here. So if this series is going to be successful, there will be another continuing series. So 3 months, if you take the maximum time that the subscriber will be glued to this serial, then if it's going to be two seasons, then he will be glued with this company for 6 months. And assume that there are two different serials. So what would happen? Two different serials, there will be total of 26 episodes, okay, with two seasons, that gives you 52 weeks or 52 episodes. Okay, 52 episodes, like each week you put one episode, that comes to 52 weeks. And finally, an entire year will be wonderful. But this is on an assumption that the series will be a hit. We'll move to the next paragraph. CouchUp has a policy of bidding for the exclusive rights to broadcast TV programs. So if there's any TV program like series or serial, they even buy the license from the production house. Contracts usually give CouchUp the right to broadcast a program for 5 to 10 years and guarantee that no other broadcaster will be granted a license to broadcast the program for 6 months from the commencement of CouchUp's right. See, exclusive rights offer makes CouchUp differentiate from its competitors. So this exclusive period of 6 months gives a competitive edge for CouchUp, that CouchUp can portray that this exclusive TV serial or TV series is only with CouchUp, and customers have to come and watch it, and they have to subscribe it. So that is the area where they can play. So exclusive rights are wonderful for this company. When CouchUp buys a season, it can either, so he in this paragraph he tells us about whether the episode has to be each in a serial, whether the episode has to be launched immediately. Okay, all episodes has to be launched immediately, or it has to be delayed and released one episode every week. Okay, so the assumption which we made here, assuming one episode per week, is not an assumption. You can even derive it from this paragraph here. Okay, from this paragraph here. Okay, so the context here is whether CouchUp can release all the episodes at one shot, or release each episode in a week's time, so that it builds a little bit of excitement. If company offers one episode at a time, it gives more customer retention. Customers are like glued to the company. They want to view the content, they want to view the serial, so they will be like glued. But there's a problem that customers can also binge watch the entire serial in 1 week and might cancel his subscription. So customers, there are some customers might wait till all the episodes are released week after week, and finally on one single week they will sit and watch all the episodes and they will be happy. So they won't pay. So the effect which we said here, 52 weeks of where the customer will be glued to the company, might not be available. He might even watch in one or two subscriptions and end it. He won't even pay 12 month subscription. So that I think is very key here, because it affects the business model. So this point, okay, so this point and this point are absolutely important. So here he says about movies. So we are not going to discuss all the things here. So here in this paragraph and the previous paragraph, they tell about the movie content, how they buy it and how they retain it, what is the exclusivity period and everything here. This is the key element here, this paragraph. CouchWeb also produces its own TV program. CouchWeb does not want to depend upon the production houses to get its content. So they have actively trying to create their own TV programs and movies. Having produced several highly popular TV series, CouchWeb attracts top writers, producers, actors to work on its project. Its movies have relatively little discussion from film critics, partly because they are rarely released in cinemas and so they attract less publicity. CouchWeb tends not to license other broadcasters to show its TV programs and movies, although it does release them on a DVD after they have been shown. See, this entire paragraph tells us what is the competitive advantage that CouchWeb has in relation to its competitors. Its content, its own created content. So TV programs is what they want to concentrate, and TV programs is what has seen. If you see here, TV programs having produced several highly popular TV series. These TV series are popular, so it means it attracts a lot of people. They subscribe, they watch. So, but at the same time, movies attracted little discussion. So movies are not doing that well. So the company tends to put more emphasis on the TV programs here. But either way, this creates a huge competitive advantage for the company here. Okay. This entire content which has been created is not sold to any other outlet or any other company, and the exclusivity is being retained by CouchWeb alone. So this is your page number 8. This is an absolutely interesting part, page number 8. Here, if you see here, they have given you two pie diagrams. So TV programs, who are the production houses who are creating TV programs, and who are the production houses who are creating movies. Okay. If you see the pie, CouchWeb is only 16%. Other major parts are like split between Pinto Studios, Magic Media and Ron Steel Production. And you can, if you see movies, CouchWeb again has only 6%. So you can identify here, TV programs is where CouchWeb concentrates. That's why they have 16% of the production here, of the content which is being produced is held by CouchWeb here. And only 6% of the movie produced and content are held are here. So CouchWeb is relatively a small player here. But if you remember in previous page, they said that CouchWeb is a strong media company. So how can this happen? Because CouchWeb could have bought from other studios and other people the rights to telecast those programs or stream it. So that right the CouchWeb would have bought. But look at here. If you combine both the TV program and the movie, okay, look, Pinto has 27% of combined market share in both. Magic has 32, Ron Steel 20, CouchWeb 11, and others together only 10. So how did I derive it? It's 23 plus 32, 55. Add both 23 and 32, you get 55. So all the pie diagram put together is 100. This is also 100. So put together, they are like 200. So 55 by 200, we get 27%. So this 27 represents the total content which is being produced by the Pinto company. So they are producing 27% of all the content here. 27% of all the content here. So who is the big player? I think big player number 1 is Magic Media, number 2 is Pinto, number 3 is Ron Steel and CouchWeb.